Everybody.
Hello, hi. It's Sam and Keisha again.
Hey.
Hello. So today we are going to be talking about
self-worth.
And Keisha is going to start us off here by telling us first about what self-worth actually is.
Self-worth. Well, how do we or you normally view yourself, and how do you carry yourself, how do you take care of yourself? Those are all things when you answer that make up your self-worth, I think. You know, the value, I guess, that you have, you know, what is your value to yourself? Self-worth. How much are you worth to yourself? Well, it better be a lot.
Because you're wonderful and beautiful, and I believe that everybody has something to offer in this world. Because you were created beautifully and wonderfully, and we are going to give you at least 8 tips on how to increase self-worth. So my first tip that I have is create a grateful gratitude journal about yourself. Every day I want you to write at least 3 things that you love about yourself. I recommend writing them instead of typing them on your phone or computer, because that way it really gets into your mind and your subconscious, and I would recommend it being something that doesn't have to do with your appearance, ladies. And men, nothing to do with your work ethic. I want it to be something...
Work ethic.
Yes. No work ethic, because that's not who you are. So these are things that have to do with your essence. So we're talking about, are you a kind person? Are you a giving person? Are you a generous person? And then I want you to explain or give an example as to when the last time you were generous or kind or loving or loyal, these types of things. These are your character. This is your character.
Or faithful.
Mm-hmm. Or somebody that's maybe artistic or...
Yeah, what are you good at? Mm-hmm. You know, those type of things.
And these are also tips that have really helped me in my journey. And it's also, in general, helpful to be grateful or thankful in general, because it releases happy hormones in the brain. So the next tip that I have for you guys is to helping other people in a way that you want to be helped. So, or in other words, everyone has a way of like a love language. Like, some people enjoy helping others by giving compliments or giving gifts or kind of ways in which helping others, because everyone is connected in the universe. We are all a part of everyone, and everyone is a part of us. So if we're all connecting, then we have a better sense of belonging.
Adding to the self-worth list. One day I just woke up and I was like, oh, wow, I do a lot for people, and, you know, I'm very giving, and, you know, I try to do as much as I can, you know, when I'm thinking about it, and I never really noticed that before. I mean, it's been a long journey of getting sober, so there's lots of things that I kind of realized, you know, in the process of, self-worth was extremely important. I was, putting up with a lot of bullshit from people and, hanging around with the wrong people and wondering why I felt so shitty, and it's because I had no self-worth. I didn't hold myself at a very high, I didn't hold myself up on a very high pedestal at all. I was always feeling very low. And then when I realized my self-worth, it changed my life. So anyways, yes, helping others is huge, makes you feel good. And what's next?
And this is also going into not being around negative people as well. So these are people that are going to make you, or often make you, feel bad about yourself, and you don't need to be around these people. So this includes should relationships. So sometimes people stay in relationships or friendships because they feel like they should. It's very simple. If the person isn't making you feel good, then you don't need to be around them. Very simple. It's a blessing to realize that, trust me.
Yeah, every time you hang out with somebody, if they make you feel less than or bad or uncomfortable, that's lowering your worth to yourself. It's not thinking very highly of yourself. You know, would you put your mom through that, or, you know, somebody that you hold dear to your heart, would you put them in that place? If you wouldn't put them in that place, then don't put yourself in that place.
That's really good. So we're also, actually that's a good point, because we're also moving on to people that inspire you. Be around people that make you happy and excited and energized and have a positive outlook on life and
motivating.
Yes, very motivating, which also lifts your spirits and happy vibrations. So it attracts more positive when you're around more positive people.
Oh. Yeah, I'm smoking, so that doesn't really say that I think too highly of myself, but, you know, it's an addiction. What do you want from me? I'm feeling guilty.
It's okay.
Anyway. Yeah, hey, I'm trying. Came over a big, long list of shit I quit. So, this is, you know,
and you know what, you really shouldn't be around people that judge you either. If you're around somebody that judges you, chances are you shouldn't be around.
No casting stones.
Moving on to the next tip that I have is, it's really helpful to ask yourself, how would someone benefit being in a relationship or friendship with me? This also goes into the qualities that you have. So say that you're a really giving friend, or you're a great cook, or you enjoy making cookies for people. Whatever it is, I want you to ask, what would be beneficial for somebody that is in a relationship or friendship with me, because everybody has something to offer.
And not, you know, giving somebody a ride or giving somebody money.
That's
those are not good beneficial things to be doing for people, because then you'll attract the wrong people and they'll be taking everything you got.
Mm-hmm.
So you should not have to give physical items to have a friend or love or whatever. So, you know, it's more of what of yourself brings out light in other people, and positivity in other people.
Yeah. And also you should do things that you enjoy or that you are good at, because that always makes people feel really good about themselves, because not everybody's good at the same thing. Everybody's good at different things, and that's what makes us unique.
Yep.
So Keisha is really good at playing the guitar, which I didn't know. She's like really good, and she plays the electric guitar, which I didn't know, and that's what makes her unique and special. So we are going into the, I'm not really counting, I don't know if this is 8 tips, but I was planning on doing 8 just to make the video a little bit short so that people stay with us. So, do you have anything else that you want to say? Also,
I can't remember. I'm good at forgetting things.
A sense of belonging is actually crucial for self-esteem. Humans are created to connect with one another, and it is proven that people that isolate emotionally or physically have a lower self-esteem or self-worth. So if you find a group that you feel a connection with or belong with, or it doesn't necessarily have to be a group, it could be a friend, and these are people that you hold the same values with. So if you both value animals or the same food or something that has like a common ground, which creates more of a connection.
Anything to bring positivity into your life is going to attract more positivity and more positive people. The search and quest for, you know, how much self-worth you have is probably a never-ending process, you know, because we're always changing, so it will probably change 10 times over again, but it's always good to look in the mirror and be self-aware and self-conscious of your actions and what you're doing on a daily basis, all day, every day. As much as you can, and you'll learn so much. So,
that's all I got. Thank you so much for sharing. Thank you so much, you guys, for watching, and I hope you got something out of this video. And if you want, you can leave some comments below on how to help self-worth or self-esteem or something that helped you along your journey. We would love to hear it. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you on our next video. Mwah! Bye!
Bye.